As the nation struggles with its health care demands, so too do veterans whose health challenges are complicated by their service. More than a million Iraq and Afghanistan vets have used the GI Bill to pursue a college degree, but they are often coping with injuries and stress that make for a tough battlefield-to-classroom transition. Our partners at KQED and the Center for Investigative Reporting bring us the story of a community college program that offers a simple solution: bring health services where they're needed most. Special correspondent Aaron Glantz has that story.
Color, present, arms.
Danny Acree signed up to be a cook in the U.S. Army.
Left wheel.
Within weeks, he was deployed to Iraq.
I was about 17 when the atrocities of 9/11 happened, and that really affected me, and I wanted to actually make some change.
He was reassigned as a machine gunner, running convoys from Saddam Hussein's hometown of Tikrit.
A lieutenant comes up to me and says, "Hey, Private Acree, you ever fired a 50 cal machine gun before?" "No, sir." He's like, "You better learn."
When he returned from his tour, his mother Lucy saw he had changed.
This is a picture of that first hug, that first embrace, and I looked in his eyes and I thought, oh my God, his eyes are now the eyes of an old man.
If anyone would ever get near me when I was sleeping, I was so on high alert that I would swing.
I was waking him up and he wanted to put a move on me to protect himself from, and then he had dreams. We watched them fairly closely, I think.
He had quite a few episodes of like
where he like saved the family from attack.
Acree held a series of odd jobs after leaving the Army. 7 years passed before he decided to get a fresh start at City College of San Francisco. But one day in English class, the war came flooding back.
Some things were brought up, in particular of a little boy who I knew, an Iraqi child that had died. And I couldn't sit in class anymore. I had to leave. Panic, heart palpitating, with all the different memories coming back, I couldn't go on.
Acree didn't have to go far for help. Within minutes, he was talking with a therapist at the on-campus clinic run by the Department of Veterans Affairs.
I went in, spoke to one of their counselors, and he just listened, had me talk it out, calmed me down, and I don't know what I would have done without him. I mean, I was kind of in panic mode.
When it opened in 2010, the clinic at City College marked the first time that the national agency charged with helping veterans had ever offered health care on a college campus. A simple solution, but one that can be life-saving.
We want to make it as easy as possible for veterans to receive services.
Hey, you got a second?
Come on in, yeah, come on in, have a seat.
Keith Armstrong runs the VA clinic at City College.
What we know about veterans, especially veterans that they're coming home from war and that have symptoms consistent with post-traumatic stress, is that they may be avoidant around getting help.
A young kid came up and said, "Hey, heard you were in the military." "Yeah." It's like, how many people did you kill over there?" "Oh, man, come on."
So how'd you handle it?
Well, you know, very politely, I said, no one today."
Senior VA officials have praised the clinic at City College. Secretary of Veterans Affairs Eric Shinseki has toured the country urging colleges to do more to help veterans.
Importantly, they must graduate. Otherwise, there's no payoff to them, to any of your institutions, or to the American people who have underwritten this most generous of education programs.
But the VA has been slow to build on the success of its City College clinic. In May, the nonpartisan Government Accountability Office issued a report saying the agency isn't doing enough to back up its $10 billion investment in veterans education. The report said that colleges were working without any guidance or assistance from the VA. And the Center for Investigative Reporting found that at 150 colleges with the largest numbers of Iraq and Afghanistan veteran students, the VA provides services at just four.
It's not an expensive program. Initially, it's a challenging program to get set up because it involves the VA doing something with another bureaucracy.
3 years on, the program remains in the pilot stage, with no plan for a major national rollout. A VA spokesman told us the agency is still gathering data on best practices. Here at City College, it was the football coach, George Rush, who saw a need.
For this campus, the commitment was these people have made the greatest sacrifices and as such deserve the most attention, and they're going to get it here.
Coach Rush comes from a military family. He and other campus leaders enlisted help from the private sector and local trade unions.
Prior to where we are today, it was very uninviting. You know, you had to stand in a hallway. It was one person coming in office at a time. There were no chairs. It was very, very upsetting if I was a veteran coming back and thinking I had my life on the line and the things that I'd gone through, and I was standing like a kindergartner in a line, you know, waiting to see somebody.
The Veterans Resource Center has made City College a destination for younger veterans across the region. Iraq War veteran Andre Rogers is president of the Veterans Alliance.
When I'm hanging out, I'm making sure everybody's safe, comfortable, and they're getting, you know, what they need.
Every weekday, Rogers drives past six other community colleges on his way to San Francisco. City College may be fighting for its accreditation, but it is the only school where he can get counseling for the flashbacks that still occasionally plague him during class. As important as the counseling is the lounge itself, says Rogers.
Whether it's medical benefits, disability compensation, their classes, any problems that they have, they can come to me or I just walk around and ask them, you know, how you doing? You know, is there anything you need?
Marine Corps veteran Edwin Del Rio is studying to be a mechanical engineer. Earlier this spring, he was struggling. He stopped going to class.
You called the suicide hotline, so were you thinking about it at that point?
Yes, I was.
What were you thinking about doing?
Cutting my wrists.
In Afghanistan, Del Rio came upon a family, including two small children, that had been shot by the Taliban. Here at the Veterans Lounge, he's been able to talk with others about his experience and learn that he is not alone.
We all slept together in the same tents, in the same camp, went on the same patrols, experienced the same hardships. And so we knew the problems that each of us might face, and we are family.
Before he enrolled at City College, Daniel Acree was searching for a sense of belonging. He joined the reserves. Acree says the community and services at City College have helped him turn the page to the next phase of his life.
I started going to school here and it just took on a whole different persona. I started getting really good grades. I started thinking maybe I can go to a really good university.
Acree hopes to transfer to UC Berkeley, and he wants more veterans to get the kind of help that he's had.
Every institution, I don't care if you've got 1,300 vets like we do or 30 vets, every place should have something like this to turn to, because who knows, one of these veterans, they might have it worse than how I had it in class, and maybe they won't get the help they need in time.
That story was part of a longer documentary that aired last summer. For more on KQED and the Center for Investigative Reporting's coverage of this issue, go to kqed.org/life-after-war.